Warriors! I've been telling you for a very long time. This has been planned out forever. Remember, cryptography, MIT, they've been working on this for a very long time, Warriors. Was crypto predicted in 1999 when cell phone technology was taken off to a whole nother level? My name is Coach JV. I am the top health and mindset coach in the world. What you believe in your heart, you think in your mind will eventually become your words and become your reality. If you can see it in your mind, eventually you can hold it right here in your hand. What you repeatedly do gets ingrained in your subconscious mind. What gets ingrained in your subconscious mind becomes an unconscious activity. And I'm going to continue to bring you videos, 1 to 2 per day, to help you understand that we are moving into the quantum financial system, a whole new economic system. And we're moving from third industrial revolution to the fourth industrial revolution. I want to make it very clear. I follow the God. I follow the life of Jesus. I'm non-religious and I accept everybody. So in the comments down below, say what you mean. Just don't say it mean. I appreciate you and I love every single person. So we're going to kick it off today on this amazing Friday. If you're watching this in the future, I love this type of stuff. I'm going to show this to you guys right here. Okay. So the key to this, Warriors, the key to this is really diving deep into what is actually happening in the long term, right? So we're all stuck in the short term. We're all stuck in this paradigm of what's happening right now. Now, if you pull yourself to a 30,000 foot overview, this has been planned out for an extremely long time. Remember, 1971, we detached from the gold standard. That wasn't by chance. It was President Nixon. 1971 as well, they created the World Economic Forum. This speech in 1999, I want you to listen to what this gentleman says. We won't listen to the whole speech. And when I close the video, I'll show you guys exactly where you can get this video. But in 1999, he is talking about cell phone technology and the new infrastructure of the financial system. Now, he doesn't talk about crypto, but watch and listen to what he says about the future of finances. And I'm going to take you through and show you all the things that are happening right now. It's just news this week. Every single day, new things are coming about cryptocurrency. And what's happening right now, they're making you very scared to move into the quantum financial system. They're making you scared to move into cryptocurrency. Remember, Warriors, we're heading into hyperinflation, where your dollar continues to lose value, right? They're going to keep pumping money into the system. Housing prices are going up, and all the smart money are moving towards stores of value. Bitcoin, altcoins, gold, and silver. So let's watch this video. Was cryptocurrency predicted in 1999?
Move from these physical dollars to electronic dollars. I think the basic technology is going to take place on the internet. I think the specific platform in the emerging world is going to be on a cell phone platform. If you look at the numbers, there are about 360 million, about 150 million online desktop-based accounts today. That number is projected to grow to about 300, 350 million in the next 5 years. However, with respect to cell phones, internet-enabled cell phones, they're just getting rolled out right now. They already have some significant penetration in Japan, in Finland, in Sweden. They're getting rolled out in Western Europe.
Okay, I want you to think about this for just a moment. 1999, going into 2000, okay, I was in the military. Where was I heading to? I was about to get out of the military, actually. In 1999, we were moving to internet-enabled cell phones. And now as we sit in 2021, look how much your life has changed. And there's a lot of people have so much resistance about this new quantum financial system, Warriors. Look how much your life has changed. Now, remember, the people who invested in this technology are some of the richest people in the world.
U.S. next year, the numbers are projected to grow from about 10 million internet-enabled cell phones today to about 1 billion in 5 years. In 5 years from now, everybody who is a member of the middle class in the emerging world and in the developed world will have an internet-enabled cell phone. And this sort of a cell in China, the numbers projected to be going go to something like 300 million cell phones, most of which will be internet-enabled. These people will have access to their bank accounts, and it will be very easy for them to move money into an account in a safe jurisdiction where the banks are not politically controlled, and they will basically be able to completely dollarize the economy. There will be no need to have any rubles or renminbi, and it will be non-traceable. No matter how illegal the Chinese Communist government says it is to hold U.S. dollars, you will have a password on your cell phone, and the only way to stop this process would be literally to shut down the telecommunications network.
Okay, so this is key right now. Look at the time, 1999. What happened in 2001? 2001, 1999, September 11th happened. which changed the way that we communicate and how they monitor us, right? So think about 1999, around that time, you could actually walk up to a gate and pick somebody up at an airport, right? After that, you had to go through this massive security process. So that was the first step into, they knew where we're heading, right? They knew that we were gonna have our own ecosystem. And so they first was monitoring, right? Then we went into 2008, the financial crisis, and you have Basel 1, Basel 2, and Basel 3, which are all designed, all by design, words. I'm going to teach you the game. So the people who invested in the future technology, what they're trying to control us, what they knew that we were going to take control of ourselves. And so that what they do with the sheeple is they take control of them through the technology.
That's the kind of choice governments like China, India, some of these other countries are going to face. They will either have to shut down the telecommunications network and make it illegal for you to own a cell phone, or they will have to basically give up the kind of monetary sovereignty they've had and the enormous power that they've been able to wield as a result of this kind of sovereignty.
Okay, so think about that. He said that, or they're gonna have to give up the sovereignty. Why do you think China, if you watched my video yesterday, just did a lottery and airdropped digital yuan to their citizens? Think about it, words. They're very smart and methodical. They've been planning this out for a very long time. They're like, okay, at this point, after the C word, after a pandemic, when we get everybody on technology, we're going to start saying, hey, we're going to get you guys to a CBDC. We're going to move you closer to the central bank. They are very methodical, warriors.
Over the last many, many years. I think this process is already full-fledged. The dollarization worldwide is going to be accelerated enormously by the technology. Now, the second theme is a little bit more speculative, and that is that getting rid of money altogether, going from digital dollars, from any kind of government-backed currency, to purely private currencies. And what a private currency, what private money, I think, fundamentally means is that there is no medium of exchange. You exchange value for value.
What does that sound like? There's no intermediary. That's what XRP is. That's what XLM is. That's what Bitcoin is. That's what all these are. There's no intermediary. There's no bank needed. That is why your banks, your big commercial banks, are moving to custody cryptocurrency. We don't need them anymore, warriors. He's talking about it right now, where it's peer-to-peer financial communication.
Rather than exchanging value for something the government says has value for value. And whenever you have this intermediate step of the government saying something has value, that's where you have the subterfuge, the sort of legerdemain come in, the game of musical chairs, where every now and then a chair gets pulled out and it turns out that you're the one holding a dollar bill that's all of a sudden become worth a little bit less.
Boom. He literally is explaining what's happening right now. You're holding a dollar bill that when they pull the chair out, you're literally going to be holding $100,000 that's worth zero. Venezuela happened right now. They literally, the money that they hold, they literally is worth zero. Zero, warriors. But when you get into cryptocurrency, you are the ecosystem. You are the bank. You give the currency value. We as the people get to take control of our monetary system.
And the kind of exchange of value for value, you know, the classic model would have been some sort of a barter model. That obviously has enormous transaction costs associated with it. These transaction costs go down in a digital age. And the kind of model that I think is the most likely to take place is one where you have other kinds of financial instruments that are very, very liquid. The one I would cite in the US would be something like an index on the S&P 500.
This is really important. So he's talking about liquidity. I've been telling you guys all about liquidity. So he's going to talk about the stock market, but listen to it and pretend he's talking about the crypto market, XRP, XLM. Listen, Algorand, all that. Listen.
100, or some sort of generalized stock market index, where instead of having currency as being the place where you have value, it is in real property, real companies, things that actually have real value. And so that you might conduct business by trading, not dollars, but trading little slivers of the S&P 500 or of particular large stocks like Microsoft or something like that. My guess is that it might be the whole stock market as a whole. And that as you trade these things, that's where you have the kind that becomes in effect a de facto currency. Now
he's literally talking about the infrastructure of the crypto market, right? Becomes a de facto currency. So XRP would be the currency. So I walk into your store, or maybe I'm in Zimbabwe, right? And I walk in, I'm like, hey, do you accept XRP? I don't need to go to Western Union to send you money. I don't need Visa. I don't need any of these infrastructures. I could just send you XRP and we have a medium exchange. Literally, and he said it's attached to a company. You got Ripple, XRP. Does it make sense, Warriors? So we're becoming, it's like a stock market type thing. He literally predicted cryptocurrency in 1999. Now remember, I'm teaching you the game. In 1999, right after that, because they knew that the Internet of Things was coming to the cell phone, then 2001 happened, right? We have our new laws that changed in regards to monitoring, right? Then in 2008, the housing crash, one of the biggest financial crashes in history. We had Basel II that came out to protect banks, right? And now we're in the biggest financial collapse again in history. One of the biggest financial collapse, like 1929. And what's happening now, we're going into Basel III, which is going to change the infrastructure of banks and make it more difficult for commercial banks to hold riskier assets, which is going to force them into this new space. The central banks know that we are gaining control, so they're going to move us closer to the central bank with the CBDC. And if you want to play the game, you can play that game, Warriors, or you can have your own infrastructure outside. They're just going to control you through the money, Warriors. That's how they do it. Whoever controls the money controls the people, controls the information. Don't forget, Warriors, you can click the link down below to join our private Warrior Academy, crypto, fitness and mindset, access to my portfolio, access to my exact exit strategy, crypto Discord, a section where you can ask questions, cryptocurrency calls, technical analysis calls on Friday, and most of our 120-day challenge, fitness, mindset, subconscious mind programming, goal setting, and vision board creation. Click the link down in the description down below to join the academy. All right, let's continue on. This is awesome here. So this is predictive programming. On June 3rd, on CNN Business, everyone you know is talking about crypto. Uh-oh, this is where we start to hit euphoria, Warriors. We're heading into it in the next couple months. What do you think about Bitcoin? This is often the first question I'm asking by my friends and family members whenever I bring up my job. And anytime I introduce myself to someone new, they tell me, what do I do? The conversation quickly turns to cryptocurrency, okay? Especially Tesla CEO Elon Musk and his obsession with Dogecoin. I've had doctors, dental hygienists, doormen in my building, and parents of kids in my son's soccer baseball team grill me about cryptocurrencies and share their stories of trading Bitcoin, Ethereum, and other obscure digital currencies. I'm not alone. I was talking to a school traffic cop recently, and he started to go on about buying Dogecoin. Dan Pintone, co-founder of brokerage firm Trading Zone, America, there's definitely no lack of interest, especially once people make a little bit of money for a lot of new investors. Now, here's the key, Warriors. If you're new to watching my videos or you're new to crypto, what's going to happen right now? You're in some sideways action, and right now it's down, right? So when you come in during this time right now, you may see some pullbacks. We're going to see some volatility throughout the next couple months, right? And then all of a sudden, it's going to go parabolic. So you have to develop patience. What I teach my Warriors is 2025 is a game. We're going to see a pullback. We're going to go through a bear market. That's when we accumulate. We go through the boring process. It's going to be a boring, patient process. If you can learn to be boring, you can learn to do the boring things consistently and be patient. That's how you become rich. This is not a get rich quick scheme. If you want to get rich quick, go to the gas station, buy some lottery tickets. Now I'm going to share with you the narrative how thick it's getting. In 1999, this gentleman was talking about basically cryptography in the cryptocurrency space, right? But he just didn't know that's what it was called. And then we went through all these different things where they predictive programmed and pushed the sheeple into technology, and they knew that the sheeple were gaining power. So they manipulated and controlled us through information, right? So let's check this out. So Anchorage to offer Ethereum-backed loans through Bank Prov. This is the first time Anchorage extended ETH-backed loans through a traditional FDIC-insured bank. This is huge. Anchorage is the first federally chartered bank that was approved by the FDIC, or the first basically bank that was approved, right? And so they're going to be doing Ethereum-backed loans through Bank Prov. This is massive. Crypto custody bank Anchorage Digital is extending its lending services with Ethereum-backed loans through Bank Prov, a traditional Massachusetts bank formerly known as Provident Bank. Anchorage already provides Bitcoin-backed loans through our other capital providers, including Silvergate Bank, and is looking to provide institutional clients bank-grade loans for their Ethereum. It continues on, whereas Norton, you know, the antivirus that you hear about all the time. So Norton antivirus adds Ethereum cryptocurrency mining to their platform. In a surprise move, one of the world's best known antivirus software makers is adding cryptocurrency mining to its products. Norton 360 customers will have access to Ethereum mining features in the coming weeks, the company said. Cryptocurrency mining works by using computer hardware to do complex calculations in exchange for reward. It is not clear that the business model, for Norton Crypto is, or if Norton will take a cut of the earnings. The cryptocurrency pitched this idea as a safe and easy way to get into mining, an important part of customers' lives. This is going to be a new job for people, new stay-at-home job, trust me. And you guys know Gary Vay is fully into cryptocurrency. You got Mark Cuban, Gary Vay. You got the whole Shark Tank team jumping into crypto. Gary Vay is, if you guys know, he's a business leader. He's a social media influencer. But Gary Vaynerchuk is launching art NFTs. This is old, linked to Ethereum cryptocurrency. I'm just showing you what this is going to look like. Whereas that's why I'm very, very bullish on Ethereum. Ethereum is going to have massive price appreciation. I'm not a Bitcoin narrative type person. Bitcoin's going to be here. Bitcoin is going to price appreciate big time. I spend most of my investments going into Ethereum, XRP, XLM, VeChain, CRO, real fundamental altcoins that I believe are going to change the infrastructure of the world. I'm really investing in the leadership teams, tokenomics, really looking at the tokenomics and understanding what is the real world solve for these cryptocurrencies. Okay, Tom Brady, I think you guys have probably seen this, Tom Brady on crypto. I don't think it's going anywhere. So watch a short clip with Tom Brady.
And blockchain technologies, I really wanted to be a part of building a great platform that could create opportunities for myself, other artists, other entertainment brands to create great collectibles. And when I was a kid, I was a big baseball card collector. Understanding that the kids now in the digital age, you know, are going to want so many things at their disposal on their devices. It's a great opportunity to be involved in that for unique collectibles, but really to provide great experiences for different fans and collectors. And it's really the next generation of interaction between celebrities and their fans, or great brands and the people who love those brands. So that's what ultimately what our goal is with Autograph, was to create a great platform for athletes, organizations, digital creators, musicians to launch their own drops and provide great experiences for people who really support them the most. And
just kind of curious, Tom, like, you know, what first caught your attention with crypto and sort of, you know, I'm just curious to know if you've gotten involved with any investing in crypto, perhaps.
I definitely have. You know, really the last year, I'd say it's funny in our quarterback room. You know, one of my coaches has been on it for 8-9 months. So we talk about it basically every day, the prices of the different tokens, how the space is doing. So it's definitely something that, again, it's on all of our minds because, you know, we're very interested. We're learning more and more about these emerging markets. So I'm a big believer in it. I don't think it's going anywhere. I think absolutely there's going to be volatility. But at the same time, knowing, you know, when there's a lot of change and there's disruption in markets, there's a lot of people that are going to fight those systems. And I've definitely recognized that in the health and wellness space. I've been someone who decided to treat my body differently than the way that everyone else treated it. I wanted to start a business that was based around the teachings and learnings that I had as an athlete, and why I continued to play football at a high level. And there's obviously systems in place that don't really preach those same things. And, you know, a lot of people will see you as, oh, you know, you're really an outlier. You're doing something different, you know, until they adopt it and go, wow, this is amazing. This is a great contribution. So, you know, again,
I've been saying this, Wars. Remember, they resist it, they sue it, they regulate it, then they join it. You just have to make it through that middle ground, Wars. And many of you aren't going to make it. I'm just going to be honest with you. Many of you are going to break because you haven't developed that patience, the persistence. And that's what I want to teach you, is discipline, Wars. Not getting caught up in pump and dumps, not getting caught up in the market crashes. You heard it from Tom Brady. If you don't want to believe me, Tom Brady's saying it right there. When you start, think about it. When I started this business, Wars, it failed multiple times. Nobody believed in my business. Nobody believed in the business. The first time I launched my online program, nobody signed up, Wars. The difference between me and other people is I'm disciplined, I'm patient, I'm persistent, I have vision, and I can see the future because I look. What I don't mean I'm clairvoyant, but what I mean by that is I methodically research and look where the market's going, not where we're at. And the thing is, Wars, there's always going to be change. there's always going to be change. People who stay stuck in the old earth paradigm that is behind us are going to perish mentally, physically. They're going to start to feel different words. We are moving into a quantum financial system. Okay. I'll give you, leave you this last bit of news, a super fired up today. JP Morgan job post hints at banks' broader cryptocurrency ambitions. The mega bank, this whole narrative is unfolding, whereas the mega bank is on the hunt for its first crop of crypto savvy employees, experience with Bitcoin and Ethereum, a huge plus. JP Morgan is in a hunt for cryptocurrency savvy candidates to fulfill a growing number of digital assets crossovers. The plan, compliance, regulatory affairs, and payments position appears to stretch beyond JP Morgan's well-documented and aggressively hiring Onyx blockchain project, an effort mostly concerned with wholesale banking. Warriors, what can I say? What can I say, Warriors? We are on the precipice of the biggest shift in generational wealth. It's an exciting, exciting time to be alive. I know this is a longer video, so if you're still here, you are a true warrior. So I'll tell you who I am. I am Coach JV, and I'm going to leave a dent in the universe. Sometimes I make people uncomfortable because my passion is mistaken as anger sometimes. My passion is to help wake people up, to open up the paradigm, the possibilities for you as a human being. I will always be servant and help as many human beings as I can. This is a mission, not a business for me. So what I've done is I've created a community of over 1,900 warriors, coming up on 2,000 warriors worldwide. Like I say, it's not a perfect community, but what we are is a community that works very hard to get you the answers you need. You have access to my crypto portfolio, my exit strategy, a Discord with about 1,500 warriors in it right now, cryptocurrency calls. You have the best part, which is my 120-day challenge to teach you discipline, mindset, vision board creation, goal setting. You can go through my exact subconscious mind programming, how I reprogrammed my mind to wealth because I kept losing my money, but this, I had to fix this. So if you're truly here right now, warriors, comment Warriors Rise because you are a true warriors, because a normal human has a 5-second attention span. So congratulations. If you have that type of patience and persistence, you're going to kick ass, warriors. Appreciate you. I love you. Everything's down in the description down below. As we always say, warriors, rise. Let's go.